I shatter that in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. 3. I bring down the plan of Satan in the name of Jesus Christ for that. Because what women don't understand, that when they get pregnant and give the pregnancy to a different man, it is, my God Almighty, it is so much sad for the children them. Come on, talk to me. Very sad for the children them. Very sad. If a man take on a pregnancy and he know that that pregnancy is not his, that's different.
Yes.
But I rise up to say, my God Almighty, what the Lord God Almighty is saying today. I preach this message already.
Yes.
And I know that preaching something like this already, what I'm about to say. I did not put this message out because that computer crashed, and I pray I will able to get that computer with those things on it, because I heard that I can get the base of whatever with, you know, even though the computer crashed, the memory.
Amen.
People of God, you know what God is saying today and how sad it is? Even like some women, some men, they don't know their mother, they don't know their father. Because you find, just like coming on the line where we have women that as where their mother has reject them. Father reject, mother reject.
Yes.
And we have people that, you know, that cry about these things. Sister Janelle was one. Sister, what's her name? Minister Gay was in the midst, she would tell it. But two women that I have prayed for, minister to, I prophesy to these two women, and the Lord used me to solve their situation, to let them know what go wrong, what is what, name it. Glory be to God, hallelujah. But just imagine, my God Almighty, there are women today that are carrying that guilt on the inside of them. What kind of guilt? The child that they have, or the children that some of them have, don't belong to the man that they married to.
That's true. Yeah.
I don't know why I don't get response from this. Everybody just quiet. Jesus. They know that they done wrong. Come on, people, talk to me.
Yeah.
I said there are children today, and you know what, the good Lord, because he's the creator, he's such a God that some of us have it wrong. Because sometimes the child might not favor the mother or the father, but it can favor some family members down in the line. Your great-great-grandmother. That can happen. So that is not something for parents to, my God Almighty, look. Oh, you don't see his jacket, this baby. You don't see the baby don't look like you. I look like the mother. It's a different man, baby. And they forget their grandmother with the twist nose. Come on, talk to me.
Yes.
They forget the grandfather with the twist eye.
Yes,
you can have, my God Almighty, a woman bring forth her baby, and she have 5 children, 4 of them dark and 1 come brown. Mother dark, father dark. But that child still is the mother dark own, and still is the father own. When they check it out and chase down the line, it's the grandmother from way back. These things do happen. So that is not the problem where children is concerned. The main problem about it, my God Almighty, is when the parents know that the child, the woman especially, know that the child don't belong to the man. People of God, that's a very sad situation right there. You know, God is not pleased about that at all. Especially with children of the Most High God that is carrying that lie on the inside. That's a big lie. Where people, my God Almighty, claim that they come through the spiritual womb. They can do the confession prior. They claim that they come to the Lord Jesus Christ and living for him today. And the child that they have don't have the right father. And they know it. And think it hard to speak about it. Think it hard to come up front. To say, you know, I have something I'm living with all these years and I want to go to heaven and rest. I don't want to go to hell and burn in the fire. And it is for me to, my God Almighty, confess. Even though, my God Almighty, some of these things can cause death. Because sometimes you might even watch movie where you see, my God Almighty, a man being taken care of a son or a daughter all the days of his life. And that son come to be the greatest, name it and what of you. And then in the long run, the mother said, he tell the son, you know, your father is not your father. That's very painful. That's very hurt. I'm speaking this to help, my God Almighty, many young people that get pregnant and know that the pregnancy don't belong to who they give it to. Come on, people. The pregnancy don't belong to who they give it to. The pregnancy belongs to somebody else. But what some women do, their eyes are so red that they will go and sleep with another man with the young pregnancy and give it to the other man because he have money. Come on, talk to me. I rise up to tell you that this is a great lie for the children of God. And these kind of lies can get you into hell. These kind of lies can get, my God Almighty, people that are saying that they are Christian, they are children of God, name it. These kind of lies can get you into hell. Because it is a secret lie. Come on, people.
Yes, amen. That's true.
Somebody's moving up with some things. Please fix it. It will mess up the recording, please. I said, people of God, that is a big secret lie. It is a lie from the pit of hell. And in the pit of hell, it's going to take back whoever tell this lie into the pit of hell.
Amen.
God is going to say, depart from me, I know you not.
Amen.
I told the people of God I could have done it as a young girl. But when I sit, you know, God good, the angel of God that was following me, have me sit down and think about it. I said, but you cannot do it because your pregnancy is about 2 months now. This guy don't have sex with you yet. And by the time he have sex with you, and you cry out to say you get pregnant in a month time, the belly is going to start to show.
Yeah.
And then his sisters, his family, father and everybody is going to know that is a false belly I give to him.
Yeah.
Because they're going to see the belly and he's going to say, but I just get pregnant for this girl 1 month now. Can 1 month belly show? Oh, she knows she get pregnant. Oh, she knows she's pregnant in 1 month. Come on, people.
Yeah,
I sat down and I think about it. I said, no, I cannot do it. You know what I do? I exit, people of God, from him. Whenever I go in the midst of where he have his business, name it and what of you. And it's not a case that I want to talk to him because of money. I did have my little money as well. Because I was singing as well, doing stage show, name it. People of God, you know what? I just exit out of it. And what God do? God allow the baby to die. Demon kill my baby, you know.
Yeah.
I went to sleep. And I used to be so tormented when I have that child. Every night, when my mother and my stepfather in the room sleeping, my brothers and sister them sleeping, I am there sleeping, people of God. And I was the only one that would wake up every night and hear footsteps going around the house. Woman wearing shoes. And hear the shoes going, come. You know those shoes that they used to make nice, come, carrying on. And people of God, I was tormented. And I would hear footsteps of my God Almighty. I would feel the presence of like somebody standing at my window. I'm sleeping and hear demon call out my name, my pet name. I hear Peaches. I wake up. I said, Jesus have mercy, who is calling me? I said, who is calling me? I would touch the water. My sister be saying, I hear that. You hear somebody call me a while ago. Go sleep, man. Go see what you're talking about. I don't know what you're talking about. And even in the morning, they don't remember that I said that to them. And I would lay there on my back, people of God. And I would be looking from one corner to other with the little lamp. You know, we sleep with the lamp back then in the house. And I would be looking from one corner to the other, being tormented. Because what? Demon is waiting on that baby to die. I think it's easy, people. My two baby. The two pregnancy I experienced, demon. The one that was witchcraft and the other one that wasn't witchcraft. The reason why it was going on so terrible with me, with that pregnancy, when I got pregnant, it was like world news. It was like CNN in the whole family.
Yes.
Because they get to understand that I was with that cousin of mine that live, my God Almighty, a wayward life. She live a dirty life. Come on, talk to me.
Yes.
And I never know. When I get pregnant, my God Almighty, I said I know who the father is, but I don't want to have anything to do with him because he's a thief, he's a pickpocket.
Yes.
And did you know that there was a reader woman? There was a reader woman, my God Almighty, that was in the midst. This reader woman, my God Almighty, she wake up one morning and she start to shout out, death, 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 young girl, going to have death in the midst. I heard that she even shout out my name. But many people did not know it was me. Many people did not know it was me. So because many people did not know it was me, my God Almighty, they did not come to tell me. And pretty soon after the baby died, while I was laying down there one night, I wake up after bring home the baby from the country. I come back to my mother. Then my mother feel happy she have a little grandbaby. I remember calling that baby Pansiana. It was the name of her flowers. And that baby, while I was there sleeping, I wake up that night. People are gonna realize that night the baby don't wake up to get breast milk or anything or to cry or anything. So I just got up. And when I hold the baby to spin the baby, I realized the baby spin over back on her face. I said, what is going on? And then I sat up and I turned the baby over. When I look, the baby turned over. When I turned the baby over, she looks different and her tongue stuck in the corner of her mouth. Her mouth opened wide and her tongue turned to her jaw. I turned the light on. When I looked, the baby was blue. Of a purple blue look, you know, that dark purple blue look. And she was as dead as dead. I start to shout out, my baby die! My baby die! My baby die! People, you can imagine 14-year-old going through those experiences. Come on, people! You see, many of you, my God Almighty, have life easy and okay and alright. Can't you, my God Almighty, understand what I'm talking about? And today we have children going through these kind of things. I come against those kind of life for young people in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. May the angel of God go in and shatter this plan in Jesus' name. May the power of God go in and bring down the plan of the enemy. Every young girl that are experienced this kind of experience, going around having sex with all kind of different men, that's the only thing I wasn't doing. Thank you, Jesus. I changed them. As one gone, another one come. But I wasn't having a lot of partners. That's the only part I did not get in. But I could not be without a man. Because of the spell. Because of the curse that put upon me. Every woman in the name of Jesus Christ that has been cursed, my God Almighty, with this kind of lifestyle, I command the curse to lift and go back to sender in Jesus' name. Jesus. Amen. Can anybody just say amen for people? People of God, I just declare something as powerful as that, and you all just sit down and say nothing.
Amen.
We have women out there, we have young girls out there going through this kind of life. You have women today sit down, my God Almighty, thinking of stabbing themselves, poisoning themselves, killing themselves because they don't want the baby. When I get pregnant, it come to me that I could put something up into my vagina and root it out. But I did not do it.
Amen.
I did not do it. I could not do it because I'm thinking of myself going to die. Not just the baby.
Yeah,
see, if you all could just understand and know the many things that the many, many people are going through, my God Almighty. Thank God for the heart that He gave to me.
Amen.
I thank God.
Yeah.
The heart of compassion for others.
Yeah.
My experience must be able to help others.
Amen, yeah.
My suffering must be able to help others.
Amen.
One of you all get and understand what I'm talking about, people of God. It must help others in Jesus' name. Because so many people are struggling and going through all kind of hell. You know, let me say something to you all. This is what came in my spirit just a while ago. You all realize that every message I come to teach, to preach, to pray, you all realize that my prayers, them is not that short. You know, they might go to 45 minutes, they might go to an hour and a little more. Or if I might pray, like yesterday, we give God praise, glory, and honor from 12:30 all the way till 4 something, we get offline.
Amen.
We came on from 12 o'clock. And you know, I always start like half an hour after. And the Lord God Almighty used me to pray for so many. Come on, people.
Amen.
We give the Lord Jesus Christ praise, glory, and honor. We're looking for great result. Great result in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We're looking for great result in Jesus' name. Great result for God's people, for everyone, my God Almighty. Whether I call the name or not, whoever tap in, whoever, Abel, my God Almighty. Many times I pray, if I did only have somebody to just put on this message right away. Can you imagine how wonderful it would be?
Amen, yes.
But it is just me alone. Yes, my neighbor can help me, but it's not easy dealing with him at times. But I know help is coming. Help is on the way. Help is on the way. Help is on the way. And what I'm saying, people of God, can you all imagine what many children are going through today? Look at it. The Bible fulfilled. Children are having children like crazy. Just imagine. Just imagine the children them that the father sleeping with. Lord Jesus Christ, have mercy.
Have mercy, Jesus. Have mercy, Jesus, have mercy.
Just imagine children that are getting pregnant for their biological father. Children that are getting pregnant. For my God Almighty, hallelujah. Stepfather. Children getting pregnant. You know, listen to me. You all don't get it yet. I wonder if you all know how many brothers get their sister pregnant.
Yes, my God.
And some parents don't know it.
Jesus.
You have brother fall in love with sister, sister fall in love with brother because of the plan of Satan. But I command the angel of God to go in the midst and disrupt this relationship and put in their spirit the fear of God so that they can repent and turn.
Amen. Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name.
Jesus,
I ask God to disrupt women, young girls that are pregnant and planning to kill themselves and kill the baby. Because they don't want it. Just imagine my God Almighty abortion today. Look, people, just imagine the abortion today. And that is one of the things that they want to my God Almighty. Bring down the president for, because he's against that. Come on, people.
Amen.
He's against women doing this abortion, killing baby. And that is one of the things them that the witches and the warlocks them want to kill him for. I'm not a politician, people. I can't even spell politics. I only can spell poly lizard and many ticks. I can only draw them. Can only draw anyone know poly lizard? Remember what poly lizard is? Those little baby lizard that never grow.
Yes.
I only can draw poly lizard and the ticks them that my God Almighty on the cows and the animals them out there in the field. That's the only thing I can do to spell politics.
Yeah.
I'm not a politician. I'm just speaking the things of God. Come on, people.
Amen. Amen.
I'm just speaking the things of God. And just imagine, my God Almighty, many women that are killing their babies. Come on, people. And you have doctors that enjoy killing babies. When I went and did my God Almighty the abortion back then, years back then in sin, I would say about 19 years ago when I did the last one, Can you imagine, people of God? The doctor was so happy doing it. Those murderers. They are murderers. Come on, people.
Amen.
You have my God Almighty. Just imagine, doctors pull baby out of my God Almighty mother's belly. They injure. Oh, Jesus Christ, God Almighty, Jesus. Mercy, Jesus. Rise up, angel. Find these wicked doctors. Bring them down in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Pregnancy that are my God Almighty. Baby that my God Almighty reach even 6 months, they're killing them.
I think that.
Baby that my God Almighty already people of God creating the belly.
God.
You have doctors, my God Almighty, killing them. Can you imagine?
Yes.
I wonder if you all get it. You all don't get it yet.
Yes.
Amen, my God.
Doctors, my God Almighty, taking out these babies. Cracking their skull. Jesus Christ, have mercy, angel of God.
Have mercy.
Angel, that my God Almighty protect baby. Go in the midst, my God Almighty. Bring down these wickedness in Jesus' name.
Yes, in Jesus' name, yes.
In the name of Jesus Christ. Mighty God.
That's right.
Robo Kotoria Bashanai.
Jesus.
My God Almighty. Women play pain. So many money. Because some women get pregnant and they were looking to do their career, or they go to school, name it and what have you. Some of them might even be with the man, and the man want to leave them in the midst of pregnancy. They say, no, I'm not going to carry this baby by myself. And somebody introduce them to a doctor that can kill that baby. You know, I know a doctor can terminate that pregnancy. Jesus!
Jesus,
and 6 months, my God Almighty, baby, the doctor go up in the midst and crack the baby's skull. Come on, people. The doctor, my God Almighty, they put them on the X-ray, and they have them there. People are going doing the ultrasound. And the doctor, my God, can able to send that injection needle down into that baby and kill that. Jesus Christ, God Almighty. Come on, people. Kill the babies, them. And then the women, they put on that, my God Almighty, they inject, my God Almighty, premature labor upon them. Come on, people.
Yes, amen.
And some of them, what they do, they give them stuff to drink and cut up the baby in. Jesus Christ, God Almighty. Cut up the baby in their belly. I wonder if you all get what I'm saying, people.
Yeah.
Cut up the baby in the belly, and then the mother have to send it out as if they have been washed out.
Yeah,
like they're having diarrhea. People of God, those things are murder.
Yes, amen.
That is the reason why us as children of God, we should pray and defend these things. Because why? We, my God Almighty, is alive today. Our parents did not do that to us. So when we hear these things, we must come up against it.
Yes, amen. Amen. True.
When we hear these things, we must come up against it.
Amen.
Mighty God of Daniel. Holy Spirit of God, What a wickedness. Some women, my God Almighty, they have abortion until, my God Almighty, they can't have no children today.
Yes,
many women you see today that cannot, my God Almighty, have children. It's the amount of some people only was blessed to have one child.
Yes.
Some people were blessed to have 2, 3, 4. But it's not everybody that you see have one child was blessed to have one child. Some people purpose that they're not having anymore.
Yeah.
They curse their own womb not to produce.
Yeah.
They do everything in their powers not to have a next child. I'm telling you, all people of God, you all don't understand. I get pregnant 6 times. My first child, I lost it, and I have 3 abortions. Can you imagine? I wish if I have all those children today. My last abortion that I do, that child could be, what, 19, 20 today. Come on, people.
Yeah.
That child would be 20 this year. 20?
My God.
That child would pass the worst.
Yes,
I understand that I, and those days, why I do it, because I did not even live anywhere, people. I was sleeping on people's floor.
Yeah.
I could not get a place of my own. When I do get somewhere, I lost it and I'm moving from one place to another. Those days, I was moving more than a moving truck from one state to another.
Yeah.
And it come to me, my God Almighty, to get rid of the baby. You all don't understand. When I think back on these things, I don't worry, I don't like pine, but these things come in my spirit like even now. I wish if I have my children them with me.
Yes.
Come on, people.
It's true.
I wish. That's why the Lord God Almighty, listen to me. That's why the Lord the God Almighty have me to be like a Sarah that is a mother for many children all over the world. To pray for God's people.
Amen.
Come on, people. To pray for God's people.
Yes, amen.
To be a spiritual mother. To pray for God's people out there.
Amen, amen.
Because God knows my heart. When I was doing those things, I didn't have no sense. Didn't have nobody to sit with me and say, don't do it. Lord Jesus Christ, have mercy.
Yes.
The few friends them that I was keeping, they was my God Almighty abortion mother. They love doing abortion, so they introduce it to me.
Yes,
can you imagine? I know of this woman, she have one child and the rest of them she abort them. How she do that, I don't know.
Oh,
you can imagine, you have a woman having 9, 10, 12 abortion. Look at that, people of God.
My God.
9, 10, 12 abortion. You'd be surprised to know people have up to 15 abortion. As much as they can abort. Because you have many people in the house of God today. The reason why you see them end up and don't have any baby, they abort them. Many of them have sex and do either way abortion. Come on, talk to me.
Yes, amen.
The very pastors, them in the house of God, getting young girls pregnant and aborting their baby.
Yes.
The Lord bring to me right now a story, let me tell it. In the realm of the spirit, the Lord show me. There was a pastor man that have this woman, my God Almighty, in the midst. Claim that he love her. And I rise up to tell you, people of God, a man that is a man of God and get and see a woman in the congregation and claim that he loved that woman and get that woman pregnant, that is no love. That is loss of the flesh.
Yes. Yes, amen.
That is loss of the flesh. And the man, my God Almighty, get to deal with the woman having relationship with her. He have her, my God Almighty, to throw away two pregnancy. This is in the realm of the spirit that the Lord God Almighty have me to have to catch up on. The woman, my God Almighty, decided when she get pregnant the third time, she said, "No, I'm getting old. I can't do this no more." She let him know that she's pregnant. She said, "I am pregnant and I'm not going to abortion this time." Why this man did not use protection? Because he was a stupid, wicked man. Come on, talk to me.
Yes, yes. True, yes.
And him always have this woman, him do so much for her. She decided, she said, "I am not going to throw away this one. I'm going to keep it. But one thing I'm going to tell you, I promise you, just give me some money so that I can move to a different place and you will not hear from me again. Nobody will hear from me. I will not, my God Almighty, have no contact or nothing." And she mean it. In the realm, people of God, in the realm. I wonder if you all get what I'm saying. This is something spiritually that God showed me. In the midst, my God Almighty, the woman, she decided, my God Almighty, to carry the baby. One day he said to her, I just need to have a good day with you where we can sit down and talk." He said, "We are going for a ride." The man get this woman, my God Almighty, and he take her, people of God, on a long ride. When he get to, my God Almighty, a place, I don't know. Let me ask you all a question. In the midst, my God Almighty, of this man carrying the woman on the long ride, when he get, my God Almighty, to to a bridge, he stopped the car right there. And he come out of the car, you know, like he lean on the bridge, like he would say, "Oh, you know, this water is so beautiful. This water is so da da da," and talking to the woman. So I said to her, "Come and stand beside me now." She came out of the car. At the same time, when she came out of the car, another, my God Almighty, car happened, my God Almighty, to be on the other side. He don't know, he don't see nothing. So what happened right there? He tried to throw the woman over. Come on, people. She started to scream. She started to scream.
Yes.
And right there they called the police.
Yes.
And the police came. Now, if this man did just allow that woman to go about her business, the guilt would be with him, but nobody would know nothing. As well as somewhere down the line, whatever in secret would come out in the open.
Yeah.
But whatever he did probably would torment him and he had was to speak it out. But when you find some of these men are very wicked and have no fear for God, they will keep secret until they die. And they will not repent. They will not repent from nothing.
Yeah. It's true.
People of God, the man was caught in his act because he wanted to kill the woman. He got caught in the act.
Yes.
I wonder if you all get what I'm saying.
Yes.
He got caught in the act. The police came.
Yes.
And they arrest him. In the midst of everything I believe, my God Almighty, the woman almost died, but she did not die. She did not die. Glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
She did not die. And what you think happened? He lost his pastorship, everything, people, because what? It becomes like CNN. Come on, talk to me. It was all over the news. Talking about in the realm of the spirit, people. That's the story I got. What the Lord God Almighty revealed to me. And it's only if somebody hear this message and know about it can say, woman of God, something like that happened for real.
Yeah.
If that man only did allow that woman, only allow that woman, people of God, to bring forth our baby. Come on, talk to me. It wouldn't happen. You can't imagine?
Oh my God.
You'd be surprised to know the many women today in church that don't have a child because they keep getting pregnant for these men and they're having them to do abortion. Hey!
Yes.
They're having them to do abortion. You know the only abortion that God forgive. Listen to this. The only abortion God forgive is those that speak out about it.
Mm-hmm.
The ones them that keep it a secret and hide it. And don't speak about it. God don't forgive them for it. Come on, people.
No.
They don't repent about it. They just do it and it look like nothing to them. There is no forgiveness for those pregnancy, for those abortion. That's a guilt and a wickedness that many women are living with. And believe they and God is friend. Come on, talk to me.
Yeah.
Believe that God and them is friend. Oh yes, they cry. Oh yes, they, oh Lord, forgive me, Lord. And but you see, when you see what I'm trying to say, it's not just one time they do it. I did mines in sin. I did mines when I was serving God. Because my time of serving God is 14 years and odd now. And that child would be 20. That child would be 20 in the summer year gone. Because it was in the summer that I remember having intercourse with that man in New York City. Come on, talk to me. So that child would be 20 today. That was way back when I was in sin. When I just came to this country, 97, people of God. And if you check from 97 until now, when I got pregnant, that child would be 20 today. Come on, people.
Yes.
And I talk about these things all the time. I confess my sin. Come on, people.
Yes, amen.
I don't keep these secret sin to haunt me. Because these kind of secret sins will haunt you.
Mm-hmm. Yes, amen.
Just like how I said, there are many mothers that get pregnant and don't want to give the father the wrong baby. Come on, talk to me.
Yes.
Secret sin. God don't forgive you for secret sin like that because you did not repent. You don't confess, you don't repent, and you don't let it be known. Some children asking, where's their father? Just like our sister Myrna was crying out, she don't know her father. Mother Janelle, the same thing, name it with whatever name. Some parents are wicked. Come on, talk to me. Very wicked.
Yes, yes, yes.
I pray for them in the name of Jesus Christ that even you will find God. I pray that God will have them to lead them to this message. Lead them to it, people of God.
Yes.
So that yes, they can be able yes. to open up their mouth and repent.
Amen.
Repent and confess of their wickedness.
Yes, amen.
Some parents tell their children, your daddy died. He was trying to steal away and he drowned.
Mm-hmm.
Your daddy died on a boat. They shot him, they kill him. When some people, you know, you have some people from they were born, they're still living at the same place until today.
Yes.
And when you take a stop, the neighbor, listen to me, the neighbor husband is the father for that child.
Yes,
and the child see that man going and coming and don't know. And that man take on to the child and that man will even be kind to the child. Every time he see the child, he always giving the child money, always this and always that. And the mother keep it as a quiet. Come on, people.
Yeah.
Some of them end up kill the woman that the man is with and take over the man completely. Wickedness. I come against those wickedness in the name of Jesus Christ right now. And I pray that there will be confession upon many, my God Almighty, that is hiding their children, Father. Confession. Even if the father die, let the child know that that man was the father.
Yeah. Amen.
Wickedness, people of God, wickedness. God have me to escape out of it in my sinful days. Because what? The angel of God speak to me and tell me not to do it. I listen to that voice.
Yeah.
But what about the many that is not listening to the voice? Can you imagine?
Yeah.
Can you all imagine, people? May the Lord Jesus Christ help many children today, my God Almighty, that making plan to get married, involve my God Almighty with the wrong man, making plan to get married, and what happened? The man forced the woman to have sex with them. Can you imagine this kind of situation? Children that has been, young girls that has been tricked, and you have some young girls, my God Almighty, forces reach them and they want sex before the marriage. Never have sex before, but they get stupid and said, oh, you know, I can have sex with him and hold him that he don't marry to nobody else. You have men telling women before they get, I'm talking about women in church now, you know, in the church. You have men that is telling women, I don't want to marry to no, to what they call it, like no pussy in bag.
Not bad.
Yeah.
I'm not married into no pussy in bag. I have to know what I'm getting. What if when I have sex with you, your vagina don't taste, feel good. This don't nice. That I don't enjoy sex with you. I have to do it before I get married.
Yes.
Telling these women all kind of things, and what happened? Bam, women get pregnant, my God Almighty, and then wrong thing happen. Women have to be by themselves. Come on, people, you can imagine this situation. I pray this time, this minute, in the name of Jesus Christ, for those mothers out there that, my God Almighty, going through these kind of things, for the Lord God Almighty to protect them and help them so that they don't even go into abortion. And for the ones them that decide to carry their children, may the peace of God Almighty transform their mind. May they able to repent and turn in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ before it's too late. Confess yourself to the Lord Jesus Christ and repent and serve the Lord God Almighty. And carry your baby. Carry your baby. Carry your baby. Don't abort it. Carry it. Because the Lord God Almighty is very merciful. The difference with Mary. Mary get pregnant as a virgin, but it wasn't a man that sexed her. It was the Holy Spirit that lodged that baby in her womb. So she was able to get pregnant to carry a baby. That's the difference with Mary. But it is for us as children of the Most High God to get married and have a baby. But look at it. It's been happening from the days of old. God is not going to kill nobody if they get pregnant like that. All he needs is for you to repent and turn. Not to keep doing it. I come against it in Jesus' name. I come against that spirit. That spirit will lift from out of the house of God. I bind up that spirit, that my God Almighty spirit of loss. I bind it up that it will leave from out of the house of God, so that women inside the house of God will not keep getting pregnant and don't have my God Almighty is not married. I come against it.
Yes.
I come against it in the name of Jesus Christ. But I pray, my God Almighty, that the Lord Jesus Christ will have mercy.
Have mercy,
my God Almighty, and find these single mothers. Find all the single mothers that are pregnant, that are going through pain and agony. Even if it's a married man, they get pregnant for. May the Lord God, the angel of God, find them, my God Almighty, and bring comfort to them and provide for them.
Amen.
The many, my God Almighty, men that are getting women pregnant and don't want to take up their responsibility, I command the angel of God to go in and provoke their spirit, arrest them, and let them go, my God Almighty, and stand and take up their responsibility. In the name of Jesus Christ. You have some women today, they are afraid to talk to the Father because of witchcraft and obia. Come on, talk to me.
Yeah.
I said they are afraid to talk who is the Father because of witchcraft and obia, and because they are afraid of the women that they get pregnant for their husband or for their man. Come on, talk to me.
Yeah, amen.
You have women out there, they are afraid to talk who pregnant them. They're afraid.
Yeah.
But I pray that my God Almighty, the power of God will move in and black and stop these kind of things, that there will be protection for many women. Women that have been raped, they don't have to do abortion. They can carry their baby. Carry your baby.
Yes.
Carry your baby even though you have been raped. It doesn't matter. Carry your baby. In the name of Jesus Christ, carry your baby. That baby will come to be doctor, lawyer, name it. That baby will come to be one of the best baby that you can ever know of. I know of a young miss. She was strayed away by her friend and go and get pregnant. And the pregnant, she get pregnant. She bring forth her baby as a young girl. Thank God for her mother. We were very close in family, as family friend. And that young miss bring forth her baby. And the mother take care of that baby, because the mother, my God Almighty, the mother, I think they happen to go and meet with the father. But the mother herself take care of the daughter and the baby. And that baby born, my God Almighty, lovely young miss. I believe she get married by now, having other children. Lovely young miss, and I believe she's serving the Lord Jesus Christ as well.
Amen.
Who is that? Look here, call to that Lord Jesus Christ. Every time this woman with her talking, Jesus, help. Help, Jesus Christ. Help, help, help.
Whoever that's talking in the background, mute your phone, please. Mute your phone, please.
I'm telling you, people of God, so many ways, different ways of women getting pregnant. Rape.
Yeah.
Being raped and get pregnant. You don't have to abortion the baby unless the doctor wash you out early.
Oh.
That's a different situation if the doctor wash you out early. Like, you just get pregnant, just get raped, call the cops. Cops come in, they take you to the doctor. I have been there, people of God, I can talk about it. When I got raped, I was in my house when the thief come through my window. He come inside, my God Almighty, and he take me out of my bedroom with a long knife. The landlord was right beside me in his room. He didn't know what was going on. My two children, them was sleeping in the living room part. While I was in the room, I was waiting on a man that I was involved with. So this man could have come in and killed my children, them. Look at that. Oh, God, have mercy. Thank you, Jesus. Listen to me, people of God. Some of you fussy. Some of you is also fussy about this, that, and you want this from God, and you want that from God. You all need to go back in your memory box and start to thank God for things that he have you to escape out of. You all need to look back and thank God for things that he has escaped you out of. My two children could have died. They could have raped my little baby girl, 3-year-old. They could have raped my 9-year-old son and come in and rape me and kill me. Come on, people, all of us could have get raped by that man.
Yes, Jesus.
And my son, my God Almighty, my son, if I should ask him today, he will say, yes, mommy, I remember, but I don't dwell on it. He was, my God Almighty, he's like he was getting out of his mind when I was raped. He peeped through the place and see the man on top of me, people. He was 9. He lay down, my God Almighty, as if he's sleeping and hug his little sister beside him. The man look around there and see them, my God Almighty, because it's just like the living room. You have a big living room and you're part of a little room for them.
Yeah.
I put a bed and a dresser right there for the two of them to sleep on. When saying so, me and the two of them could sleep in one room, but because my body was in fear, furious, my God Almighty, anger for man, because I've been cursed. So that's why I put them there by themselves.
Yes.
And when the man came in to rape me, my God Almighty, I lay there, people of God, and I'm crying and I'm saying, and him saying, don't make no night. I said, please, leave me alone, don't do it. I even go as far as tell him like that I have AIDS, and he didn't believe me.
Yeah.
I said, I'm sick, you cannot have sex with me. But he didn't believe me, and he could have killed me for that.
Yes.
Because all he's saying is that he's going to kill me. When that man, my God Almighty, do what he have to do with me and he run off. And but what he doing? He come through the window. Then he, my God Almighty, go to the door and pull the door and the grill. Because he's not going back. A thief don't really enter back through a window unless nobody's home.
No.
The only way a thief enter back through a window when they come in is when somebody's home. But if somebody's home, they are not going to enter through the window. And if you're sleeping, they're going through the door. They're going to walk out as if they own the premises.
Yes. True.
And after that man raped me, my God Almighty, when I got up, people of God, I start to shout loud on the tip of my voice. Rape! Thief! I forget, people of God. I start to scandalize myself. Shouting out, rape! Thief! Because I was so devastated, people of God. I was out like I'm getting out of my mind. Remember, you know, people of God. Dear, let me say this to you all. And I must preach it and teach it. Mother, even write it down for me. There is no enjoyful sex like the sex that you know you are in agreement with. Any other sex that you get that you're not in agreement with, it bring pain and agony to you. And that sex bring pain and agony to me. I run out. There was a man next door. I run straight into his house because that's a house that those people and me were very close. Another home was close, but it was a little further up the road. Because I have friends as that's why I said God good enough for me to be living in this place 7 years and don't have one friend, one neighbor. Can you imagine? Try to make friend and people delete me out. I call it, you know, your delete number. They delete me as a friend. Years now I'm living here without any neighbors. One came beside me. I talk with her. She's like associate. I can't be friend with her because she don't want God. She don't want God none at all. So I'm all by myself, being back in with 1, 2, 3 neighbors. And none of them want to be my friend. Not one. a church beside me that I used to go to, none of them want to be my friend. But anyway, that's not the talking. What I'm saying is that I was involved with other friends in the neighborhood. I had friends back home because I was a friendly person. I was an entertainer, people. So people know me. And in the midst, my God Almighty, what you think happened? When I got raped, I run over one of my neighbor's house with my voice on top. The neighbor hear it and he run out with his gun. And he said, where's the man? I said, he go that way. The landlord was so carefree. The fence break down at the back. I said, why don't you fix this fence? Anybody could just come through it, walk through it. Remember, I have my children, I'm living here. Anything can. That man ignore it. If that fence was fixed, that thief would get killed that morning or get shot or something, because the man would able to catch him.
Yeah.
If he did only fix up the fence that break down, the thief run through the fence and run on the other side of the road. And I called, he said to me, you have to call the police, and we call the police. When the police come, you know them and them heap of rigmarole thing and think it's a setup or what have you, and da-da-da-da, name it. And I'm telling you, I was in fear. And right there, what happened? They took semen, they take the very panty that I was wearing. They said they have to take it. So just imagine, they send me without one. Can you imagine? And right there, they send me straight to the doctor. The police themselves take me to the doctor. They take me to the doctor. I went to the doctor. They say I have to call a family member to come and, you know, get me, or they give me money to come home back, whatever. I call my brother, and he come. Me and his wife come. And the doctor, they right away, people of God, they give me pill. So that's if should in case anything I can pass out, whatever, the discharge. Because that wasn't no baby yet.
Yeah.
It just happened, just couple hours, but they washed me out. That's different. That's not abortion right there. Come on, people.
No.
And my God Almighty. If when some people get raped, they talk it right away, they would get help. But some people get raped and they keep it because they are ashamed of it. But look at me today. I can use this rape and talk it to help people.
Amen, yes.
I thank God for that. But when people get raped and get pregnant, they don't have to abortion that baby. That baby, regardless of the rape, the child don't have to come. Even if it's a boy baby, that baby don't have to come be a raper.
No.
That baby don't have to come and be a thief. Because the good Lord God Almighty, don't even pray in your sinful days, and he can wipe out those semen out of that child. Come on, talk to me. Those kind of generational curse. He can wipe that generational curse out of that child.
Yeah.
But there are some children that come from rape or thief, name it. That blood sit in them, people.
Yeah.
Because you know why that blood will sit in them? Because it's not just the man that rape you is a thief. It is a generational following up where grandfather, grandmother from way back, stealing come right up in the family. Raping coming right back in the family. Doing all kind of wickedness right back in this family. So that is a blood set right there. That can cause that child to come and act like it. But in the midst of everything, if you get saved, you can easy well cry out to God, and God can heal, delivered, and set free.
Yes.
That's the God I know of. And that's the prayer I'm praying for many today. That the Lord God Almighty will rise up in the midst. The Spirit of God Almighty will take over, move in might and in power. Capture, my God Almighty, every plan of Satan in the name of Jesus Christ. And bring down the plan of Satan. Rekoda bashata rabakindi. The power of God is powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword. Come on, people, can cut down to the very marrow. And I pray for every woman that is going through these things with themselves, their children, name it. If you have some women right now, they pregnant and their children pregnant. Can you imagine those pregnant upon pregnant?
Yes, true, speak Holy Spirit.
Pregnant for the same man, mother pregnant for her daughter, husband. Daughter pregnant for their mother, husband. Come on, talk to me.
Yes.
So much things. I pray for the power of God to go in and deliver and set free. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. May the power of God will arise, and the enemy of my God Almighty, these people that are going through this kind of situation, that is the reason why my God Almighty, these people need prayer.
Yes.
And this prayer and this message is for all kind of situation pertaining to pregnancy. All kind of situation. Protection, prayer for all kind of situation pertaining to pregnancy. Carry your baby. Carry your baby. Those that pregnant. Those that don't ready. If you know you have been tempted by the devil, protect yourself. But don't get pregnant and abort it. It is against God. It is not right. I bless the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I glorify him. I honor him and I thank him for having me this morning. I know many didn't be, many might not believe I was going to be online this morning. For all those long time I was on the line. That's why I said, call in every morning. You never know when the Lord will do it. When I got up this morning, I went to the bathroom early. I said, God, what are you telling me? That I must fly the line this morning? And the Spirit of the Lord, God Almighty, said, pray the protection for pregnancy. I said, glory be to God. Then, I'm feeling strong, fit, and everything in my body. But by the time, my God Almighty, I sat down, I start to feel very tired. Because I've been up on my feet from 4 o'clock yesterday morning until, my God Almighty, almost 11 o'clock last night. I've been on my feet doing all kind of things. With the line, wake up this morning, yesterday morning, make preparation because I was having, my God Almighty, one or two people coming over to see me. Which, you know, I don't get visitor. Thank God for them. God bless my nephew and my God Almighty, my grandbaby, DJ Naya, and her brother. Thank God for them. So I was to wake up, my God Almighty, and do so much things. And then the line in the midst and after the line, then I start again with, you know, getting dinner together, doing this, doing that. And they didn't leave here that early. They leave here probably about 8 o'clock. So after that, my God Almighty, I was to do what I have to do. I didn't eat until about 10 o'clock last night because I didn't even feel like eating. Because I was to have prayer with them, and I decided that, you know, I want to really pray for them, name it and one of you. But thank God for Jesus Christ. Then I wake up this morning, the Holy Spirit said, fly the line. Can you imagine? When your life is not your own, you better be obedient to God. Because I've been praying to the Lord and saying to the Lord, Father, I need you to pray through me a prayer for pregnancy. Long time I said to God, he just bring it forth. That's how God used me. I have to make myself available for him to use me for these things. And I pray for the many babies that are born. They're born and they are hungry. No food to give them, God. Jesus. Angel of the living God, visit these baby. Visit these baby and feed them. God Almighty, send help, send help, send help.
Yes, Lord.
The ones them that are dying for hunger, help, Lord. Help the children, them that are dying for hunger in the name of Jesus Christ. Mothers are dying because they don't have anything to eat. They can't feed their baby. There's nothing in the breast and the baby sucking on the dry, dry breast. Jesus. You have baby sucking breast until blood come. Come on, people. Baby, you have baby suck the breast until blood start to come because there is no substance, not even water in the parents' body because they are living in places where they don't even have water. And baby sucking on the breast, nothing is in the breast for them to suck on. The pregnancy, my God Almighty, no nutritious, nothing. Jesus Christ, have mercy, angel of God. Go out and help. Send help, Lord Jesus Christ, send help. Our Father God, with these women, tie their womb so that they don't produce. Tie their womb.
Yes.
Tie their womb, God Almighty, so that they don't produce. Tie their womb, God. They don't have protection. They are living in various places and getting children and having baby upon baby and baby born and die because the baby died for hunger. Jesus Christ, tie their womb. Tie these women womb so that they will not get pregnant. Because God Almighty, you see what is going on. It sounds funny, people, but when God tie it, he can pull it. Come on, talk to me. This is not a witchcraft and obia thing. This is about the Spirit of God that can tie. Just like how he come in the midst of myself here, 2000 and my God Almighty 2, and what he did, he take away that sexual urge from me so that I don't have no sexual urge because it was the biggest blockage for me to serve him. Bam, in couple months after, he come in and capture me. If he do this to me, he can tie the womb. He can block the womb so that no baby don't go into those womb. Children of those parents that have been children and don't have nothing to feed them. And they, the parents dying, the children dying. Jesus Christ, have mercy. Angel of the living God, get busy. Busy, busy, busy and go in and do it. Do it, angel of God. Do it, angel of God. Sarah, angel Sarah, John mother, go in and do it. Go in and do it. Mary, go in and do it. I command thee, the work of God's hands, to do it in Jesus' name. So that these women will be protected by the Holy Spirit of God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you, we bless you. Thank you for today, oh God. Thank you for this prayer, Lord Jesus Christ. I bless you in the mighty, precious name, oh God. I want to glorify your holy and your precious name. Oh God Almighty, as you arise, let the enemy, Lord Jesus Christ, of your people's soul scatter. Angel of the living God, get busy. Bring down every forces, every darkness, every spirit that is not of God. In the mighty precious name of Jesus Christ, Father God, have your divine way. For there is no other God like you. You are the only true and living God. You are the great high priest, hallelujah. You are the great I am, God of Abraham, Jacob and Isaac. Rise up, Lord Jesus Christ, and take a stand against every wicked plan. In the name of Jesus Christ, women, my God Almighty, that are getting pregnant by other women, husband, my God Almighty, and bringing all kind of wrong, Lord God Almighty, witchcraft, obia, in the midst to cover, I scatter by the angel of God with Holy Ghost fire, Elijah, go in and bring down their plan, Ribiasha, mama, kende, bring down their plan, powerless, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, let God arise and the enemy scatter. In Jesus' name, let the enemy scatter. In Jesus' name, as God arise, let the enemy scatter. In Jesus' name, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, oh God Almighty, mighty, mighty Father, be thou glorified. I am lifted up in the mighty, precious name of the Lord Jesus Christ. As I give you praise, God, and as I give you glory, and I give you honor, Keep your people them covered, oh God Almighty. Keep them under the shadow of the Almighty God. And let them, my God Almighty, able to feel your presence in the midst of them as they cry out to you every moment. God Almighty, do it. For you are Lord, your God, and your King. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Can we lift up the Lord Jesus Christ?
Lifting up their hands, they bow their heads and worship the Lord with their faces to the ground. When we receive a word from the Lord, our answer should be, amen. Let the church say, amen. Let the church say, amen. Let the church say,
Hallelujah. Jesus, hallelujah. Oh, Father God, in heaven, glory to God. Oh, Lord, we give you this praise to this man. This is who you are, Lord God. Oh, when we think of the service of all that you have done for us, and when you have brought us up, come to this man of you.
Glory be to God, hallelujah. Mother Yvonne. Mother Yvonne. Are looking for great testimony.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God. Mother Yvonne, take over from there. And people of God, don't forget, continue to call in the morning. You never know when I'm on. A phone call won't do anything. All it will do is wake you up and have you to get prepared to pray. If you don't get me, just tune in on the line.
Amen.
Amen.
Tune in on the Empower, the YouTube channel. You will get something in your spirit very powerful.
Amen.
God bless you all in Jesus' name. Come on, Mother Yvonne.
Matthew 6, verse 9 to 15. Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven.
Come on, people! Give us this day our daily bread.
Give us this day our daily bread.
Jesus.
And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors.
And forgive us our debtors.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory.
For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory.
Forever and ever, amen.
Forever and ever, amen.
For if he forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if he forgive not men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses.
Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
May the Lord Jesus Christ bless and keep each and every one. May his face continue to shine upon each and every one. People of God, my God Almighty, may you all be blessed. In the name of Jesus Christ, be blessed until we meet again, you and your family. Be blessed without stress in Jesus' name, and just know that Jesus Christ is Lord over everything. Glory be to God, hallelujah. I just pray that whoever listened to this, my God Almighty, prayer and messages, that they will share it with somebody. Share it, let it go all over, and help somebody to know that Jesus Christ is Lord, and he's in the midst, and he can do great and mighty things. God bless you all in Jesus' name. While my little granddaughter, my God Almighty, sing along with my God Almighty, with my nephew Joshua, sing along with Don, thank you, Lord, and Danny McKirklin, there's no God like Jehovah. Glory be to God, hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.